God is blinding them. You know, he's blinding them to this truth so that way they cannot receive it on this side. And you see a lot of our people that, you know, they know that they're here to life, but you got a lot of them trying to, you know, a lot of them are twisting and reversing the gospel, you know, to trying to get a platform.
The fact of the matter is this society is
know, his mentor's trying to break him. You know, he's trying to break him down and trying to get him back into our captivity in our state. And a lot of people don't understand it. They believe that this, that they're going to thrive in society, but you cannot thrive in this society. Now, the society is our captivity. You know, we're in bondage. You know what I'm saying? Like, we're back in Egypt all over again. And our people don't understand that Revelation chapter 13 said this is, you know, basically, you know, in Revelation said that this is a, you know, spiritually called Sodom and Egypt. Wherefore, your house shall be crucified. You know, his image will crucify here. Because they saying that this place is, you know, white Jesus, you know, saying they painted him white, you know. And, you know, they paint our Savior white, you know, saying that this is our Savior, which is not. You know. Our people have to understand that all the way for us to get back on top is that we have to repent and turn back to the law, statute, commandments, and Yahweh, Hashem, and Al-Shah. And we got to separate ourselves from this place. We gotta separate ourselves from the ways of this society. Yeah, we do have to work and provide a living for our family. But the ways of the society, we have to separate ourselves from. We have to separate ourselves from the thinking of this society. Because the society is not gonna do anything but bring us down. It's not gonna do anything but keep us in bondage and in captivity. And we have to come back to our power. Our people need to understand that, man. Our people need to understand that this society is not meant for us. They got, you know, legislation, you know, that are in place, you know, to try to, you know, they want to destroy our people, man. They want to wipe us out, you know, off the face of the map. You know, they want us to, you know, they want to exterminate us, per se. They even got, you know, the King Alpha plan, they got Rich 84, they got all these other plans that, you know, they put in motion. You know, they want to target Black, Latino, Native Americans. They want to wipe you off the face of the planet. Because they looking at us as a problem. They saying that we're the problem. You know what I'm saying? They can wipe us off the face of the planet, everything's gonna go back to normal. You know, which we know through scripture that it's not, because the Most High is gonna take down Esau's power. He's going to take down this society. And throughout all the scriptures, you can also get it in Isaiah chapter 47, verse 1 through 2. Talking about 10, daughter of Babylon to sit on the ground. Which is talking about American Babylon the Great. He's talking about this society. It's going to be nuked. And the scripture said it's going to be 200,000 times a thousand. I mean, there's going to be 200 million missiles that's going to come over here and destroy this place. This place is going to be destroyed. You can read in Zechariah 14:12 said that you know, you're going to be, flesh is going to be consumed away while you stand up on your feet. You know, roughly paraphrase. But this society is finished. You know, you have to understand this society is done for. You can see the economic collapse. See that more people are losing more jobs, more stores are closed. And people don't know what to do, man. They don't know what to do with this society. You know, they don't know what to do. Because this society is finished. And I pray for honor to y'all about Shippy House Shop for that. Because this society is pretty much done. You know, you can't, you know what I'm saying? You can't know yourself. Because the society is failing. And a lot of our people are doing it. They're trying to store their treasures here on this side, man. You know, because it's the only thing that they got to look forward to. They don't see nothing else past this society. They believe that it's just the way things are going to be. But, you know, scripture tells us plainly in John chapter 14. For you Black, Latino, Native Americans, let not your heart be troubled. Believe my Father, believe also in me. He said, but in my Father's house are many mansions. He said, if were not so, I would have told you. He said, and I am going to prepare a place for you. by him, then you may be there also. Meaning that Yahweh Hashem El Shah is prepared to play. You know, he's prepared to play for his people. You know, saying the scripture also said that he made the world for our sake. But our people, you know, they can't see past that, man. They can't see past this society. They think that this is all they got to look forward to. But, you know, Yahweh Shah made it very clear that, you know, he wanted to prepare a place for his people, you know, the Israelites. You know, he prepared a place for us. And we got something to look forward to. You know what I'm saying? This society is failing. You know, this society is pretty much finished. And we got something better than this. That's the reason why, you can't put your trust in this society, because this society is going to fail you. You know, this society is done for. And our people need to understand that. They need to wake up and understand the fact of the matter that Mosiah is going to come back and destroy Babylon the Great. You know, he's going to take Esau, Edom out of power. Understand when they come back in the kingdom that it's more to it than that society that we in now. You know, our people don't want to let this place go because they think that this is all they got. But you know, this is not all that you have. You know, this society, you know, saying it's not meant for you anyway. You know, because in the Constitution, you know, they state that we're 3/5 of a human being. That's how low this society thinks of our people. And yet our people still want to trust in this society. They still want to hang on to this place because they can't see nothing past this place. And guess what? This place is going to be destroyed. You know, it's going to be destroyed by nuclear missiles. And it has to be destroyed. And then, you know, the society has to be destroyed, man. Esau even has to be taken out of power. Because, get what? Because the scripture, because Most High prophesied, man, through his prophets, that this place is going to be taken down. You know, for you black Latino Native Americans, you know, stop trying to believe that you live your best life. You're not living your best life here. You're still living in captivity. You know, you're the last hire that first fire in the land of your captivity. We're still in captivity. We're still under the curse until the house shall return. So you're not living your best life. You know that, you know what I'm saying? That's a lie. You know, you're not living your best life here. And those celebrities, you know, they are Israelites, they think they live their best life, they're miserable. You know, they're miserable here. You know what I'm saying? They made their choice. You know what I'm saying? They're not gonna give up their riches. They're not gonna repent. And that's another thing Yahweh Hashem El Shah want our people to do is to repent. But a lot of our people are not gonna repent. You know, they're not willing to repent. Especially, you know, you got celebrities, they got money in their pocket, you know they ain't gonna repent. You know, pray that they do, but you know, a lot of them not gonna repent because they made their choice. They chose who they gonna serve. Because in the book of Joshua said that, you know, choose that day who you gonna serve. You know, you gonna serve the gods on the other side of the floor, you serve them. Said, for me and my house, we're gonna serve Yahweh Hashem El Shah. You know, you gotta choose to go serve. A lot of these celebrities, they already don't chose who they gonna serve. You know. They already chose who they gonna serve. You know what I'm saying? But Yahweh Hashem El Shah wants you to repent. Come back to him, you know, to keep your law and statutes compared to the best of your ability. We know that the law is not going to save, but you know, we're commanded to keep it to the best of our ability. You know, because it's impossible to keep all the laws in the land of our captivity. Because, you know, even one law, we on the Sabbath day, we don't even supposed to do no service work, we don't supposed to work. In the land of our captivity, you know, a lot of our jobs, you know, we work on the Shabbat. But how else we supposed to try to keep it to the best of our ability? You know, we got to keep lost that man to best our ability. And then when grace comes in, but it doesn't give you no excuse, you know, to go out and do what you want to do. But, you know, you keep the law, statutes, commandments to the best of your ability. You know, that's part of being in the truth. You got to keep the law, statutes, commandments to the best of your ability. And also being in the truth, you got to count the cost. You know what I'm saying? You got to count the cost of being in the truth. And you also got to count the cost of what happens when you're not in the truth. You know, count the cost, do inventory, meditate upon it. You know, meditate upon the cost of being in the truth, meditate on the cost of not being in the truth. Because people that are not in the truth, you know, they're going to go through a heavier punishment than those that are. You know, those that staff and scoff and mock and talk bad about the prophet, talk about bad about being of the Lord, they're on the highway, byway, and risking their lives for freedom to bring the truth. They laughing at them, but they ain't kind of caught what happened when they're not in the truth. You know, they, you know what I'm saying? They ain't count the cost of that. But, you know, we got to count the cost. And we got to understand that we got to keep the law, statutes, and commandments, keep the ways of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shah. You know, a lot of people ain't yet to understand that this society is not meant for them. These other nations don't care about our people. Because you read Psalms 83rd, chapter 1 through 8, you know, they are confederate against, you know, you black Latinos, Native Americans. You know, they confederate against you. And you got our people still trying to be accepted of them. They, you know, let me say this. These other nations, whether Esau or Edom, they will never accept you. They will never accept you. And our people need to get over that fact. They need to get over the fact of mind that they would never be accepted in this society. They would never, ever be accepted in this society. You know, like I said in Psalms 83rd chapter, you know, all of them against the children of the Most High, you know, you black Latinos, Native Americans, they're against you. You know what I'm saying? They want to cut you off. You know what I'm saying? You know, all these plans and all these executions, Jacob Trump. You know, that's five people. And for the RFID chip, which is mark of the beast, you know, they target you black Latino Native American. That's who they want to get because the elite, they know the scripture. They know that we're the chosen people. And they want to target the chosen people. You know, they ain't worried about the other nations. They know that the other nations are going to automatically take the children. And they know that, you know, you two-thirds Israelites, y'all going to automatically take the children. Y'all docile, and you know what I'm saying, you ain't got no light in you. You want to take the chill. But they're talking to hopeful elect. So that way they can try to stay in power. Get what? Get what? Yahweh Shem HaShai going to deliver his hopeful elect from the hour of temptation. And you read the book of Revelation, I believe the second chapter, that we're going to be the devil gonna cast some of us into prison in Revelation 2 and 10. Then we're gonna be tried 10 days, you know, a certain amount of time. He said, but be faithful unto death and I'll give thee a crown of life. And a lot of our people, you know, especially those who believe Yahweh, is gonna be a martyr, gonna be put to death. You know, they're gonna be beheaded because of the fifth seal showed so them that will be here for the witness of Yahweh Shem HaShah. You know, some of us going to be beheaded. Some of us going to be killed over this faith, over the truth. But you know, two-thirds going to die a grievous death also. But you know, but the hopeful living going to be saved. You know what I'm saying? He said, be faithful to death, he's going to give us the crown of life. But this society is geared towards exterminating you black Latino Native Americans. Exterminating our people. And you know, for those who talk about you living your best life here, you know, you foolish. You're not living your best life here. You living your worst life here. You're gonna be living your best life when we be back in the power, when the kingdom of heaven be established. You know, through Yahweh's son, Yahweh Shai, and King David, and the apostles, the 144,000. You know, gonna be living living our best life then, because it was, we're going to be on top. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be ruling. And all the other nations, well, Esau, Edom, they're going to be serving us. They're going to be our slaves. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be ruling over them. You can read that in Isaiah 14, chapter 1, start at 1st through 2nd verse. You know, the main point is in verse 2, when it said we're going to be ruling over our presence. We're going to be ruling over them. And you know what I'm saying? Our best life is in the kingdom of heaven. That's why our best life is in that world. That's where we really going to be living our best life, in the kingdom of heaven. You know, that's when we really going to realize that we're living our best life. We ain't living our best life on this side. Man, we live in the land of our captivity. You know, we living our worst life. This is our hell. You know, this is Esau, Edom's heaven. This is our hell. Because we catch a hell on this side. Our people get gunned down in the streets. You know, our people are getting fired from their jobs. You know what I'm saying? They are, you know, they're starting to cut off, you know, food stamps and everything else. They're talking to our people. We catch a hell over here. And then if for you to be rich and famous, you gotta sell out, you gotta sell yourself to the devil. You gotta join your allegiance to Esau, Edom, and they make you do all types of vulnerable and despicable things, you know, behind the scenes. You know what I'm saying? You gotta get down to the program, you gotta accept any and everything, and you got your Jay talking about you living the best life. You know, you foolish, man. And Scripture tells us we're astonished cheering. No, so astonished means stupid. You know, we're stupid cheering. We think that we're living our best life over here. Very stupid to think that, you know, we're living our worst life over here. And you black Latinos in America, man, y'all need to wake up to the fact. Look what happened in the Bahamas. Our people got jacked up over there because of their sin and transgression, because they refused to repent. And there's prophets over there in the Bahamas, you know, basically telling our people to repent and come back to law, statute, commandment. You think they listened to it? No, they didn't listen. That reason why Yahushua allowed the hurricane, Dorian, to come over there and hit the Bahamas. And one boy said it stayed over there for 40 hours. It's a judgment from Yahushua. You know, that our people got jacked up because they ain't want to listen to the men of the Lord, they ain't listen to the prophets. And I'm sure a lot of them, they got jacked up, they hear the words of the men of the Lord, and they refused to argue. And that's the reason why they got jacked up and they got judged. And it's gonna be a matter of time when judgment hit America, Babylon the Great. You know, our people think they're going to just scave off scot-free. Guess what? We're gonna get, you know, judgment gonna hit this place. It's gonna hit this place just as worse. We already had shortage of food and all these other things. And y'all people talking about y'all living your best life. You're crazy. You're crazy you think you're living your best life over here. This place is gone, man. This place is destroyed. You know. And it's going to be a matter of time that Yahushua really going to rain the plagues upon this place. And we're going to see what our people going to do then when all hell breaks loose. And they see when the martial law troops starting to roll up on them, and they start to see that they're going to be riding up to these FEMA camps, these concentration camps, to receive re-education or to receive the mark of the beast, which is a RFID chip. What you're going to do then when you face two choices is either you're going to take that chip or you're going to get your head chopped off or something far worse. And a lot of our people, they're going to take the chip because they're going to think they're taking the chip, they're going to trying to stay in the society a little longer. The next chapter, Richard, Revelation chapter 14, tells them what's going to happen when you take that chip. You know, you're not going to get no rest. You know, once you take the chip, there's no repentance from that. You know, there's no repentance. You know, on this side, you're going to face the wrath of Yahweh by Shemaosha. When you do take the mark of the beast, which is the RFID chip, a lot of our people, they're going to take it. They're going to take that mark. You know, they're
they're going to take. They're going to face with times of attitude. They're going to face with the house they pay. And what's going to do, a lot of people are going to take the job. But don't let, you know, a lot of them get up in the spirit to endure. You know, to endure all these things. And they're going to come out with the child and father to come out through the door. But you know, that's it. Unless, you know, just want to touch on various topics, you know, on what's going on. And I pray that this is the best headline. I want to say, call on your power, buy a ship, power shop, buy a ship, rock and dodge. And my other city, my elders and prophets, and others, religion, brother, teach the truth all over the world. See you again with another lesson. So, God willing, try to warm my palm from your